Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Morning.
弟兄姐妹们，早安。
In the name of our Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we begin our service today.
我们奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名来开始我们今天的主日崇拜。
May the Holy Spirit help us to still our hearts before Him by singing the Lord in His temple to worship our Lord.
愿圣灵来帮助我们在神的面前安静我们的心，我们一起来唱《主在圣殿中》。
Says, may the peoples praise you, God. May all the peoples praise you. May the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you rule the peoples with equity and guide the nations of the earth. May the peoples praise you, God. May all the peoples praise you.
诗人说，神啊，愿列邦称赞你，愿万民都称赞你。 愿万民都快乐欢呼，因为你必按公正审判万民，引导世上的万国。神啊，愿列邦称赞你，愿万民都称赞你。Shall
we all stand? Let's have a word of prayer.
让我们一起起立来做一个的祷告。主啊，宝贵，这真的是天父的世界，我们可以在其中欢喜和快乐。 天父啊，感谢你又将新的一天来赐给了我们，让弟兄姐妹又再一次的可以聚集在一起来敬拜你，来称谢你的名。主啊，我们感谢你那一份长阔高深的爱，感谢你没有按我们的过犯来待我们。宝贵在你里面真的是充满了怜悯与恩典。主啊，我们再一次的感谢你在十字架上为我们牺牲的爱。 宝贵，因着你，我们的生命真的有所改变；因着你，我们可以成为神家里面的人，我们再也不被定罪。我们今天有那尊贵的身份，主啊，我们也将我们的教会都交托在你的手里面。感谢你一直的带领和看顾，主啊，我们也将教会里面的牧者，还有理事们都交托给你。求主你将你当走的路、你的蓝图写明在他们的。 身上，让他们能够可以看到，让我们的教会紧贴着你的脚中，让我们可以成为就是荣耀你的一群。主，我们也将我们今天的聚会都交托在你的手里面。求主，你大大的与我们同在。求主，你来安静我们的心，你来除掉一切缠绕着我们的事情，让我们真的可以安静的来聆听你的话语。 求主来帮助我们，透过诗歌，让我们可以进入在敬拜里面，让我们可以全心全意的去赞美你。求主，你也用得着主牧师的话语，让他的话语来释放我们的心灵，让我们再一次被你的话语来影响我们，能够更加的去有你的样式在我们的里面。求主，今天你就大大的与我们同在，我们再一次将这将我们今天的聚会从头到末了交托在你的手里面。我们将这祷告，奉靠耶稣基督的名而求，阿门。
Let us all lift up our voices and give glories and honor to our Almighty God, that all the praises and glories are due to His
name.让我们一起来称颂，来用我们的声音一起来歌唱，来称颂我们的神的名。
As the psalmist says, shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of His name. Make His praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bow down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing the praises to your mighty name.
诗人说：全地都当向神来欢呼，歌颂他名的荣耀，用赞美的言语将他的荣耀发明。当对神说：你的作为何等可畏！因你的大能，仇敌要投降你，全地要敬拜你，歌颂你，要歌颂你的名。
How great thou art!
Thank you.
seated.
请坐。
Jesus is our beautiful Savior and glorious Lord.
耶稣是我们美好的救主和荣耀之君。
Jesus' name is called Emmanuel.
耶稣的名叫以马内利。
He is with us each and every moment.
他每时每刻都与我们同在。
Jesus is our Redeemer and Living God.
耶稣是我们的救主和永活的神。
Let's sing together Jesus' name above all names.
我们一起来唱他的名超乎万名之名。
the time to Reverend Zhu with Brother Keith.
我们现在把时间交给朱牧师还有阿丽弟兄的翻译。
各位弟兄姊妹平安。
May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with each one of you.
感谢主，一年一年的这样过去。
We want to thank God for leading us year by year.
但是我们相信主耶稣的来的日子越来越近了。Which
remind us that the day of the Lord's return is drawing nearer.
今天我们开始先来学习主耶稣的话语。
Today we are going to learn from the words of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们让主的话语来提醒我们。
May the word of the Lord remind us.
让主耶稣话语来预备我们。
And may the words of our Lord Jesus prepare us.
让我们晓得我们如何来等候主的再来。
That we may learn how to wait for the Lord's return.
我们开始的时候学习路加福音21章的5到19节。
Today's passage is taken from the New Testament, Luke chapter 21, verse 5 to 19.
还是我读中文，大家可以看英文跟中文。
As usual, the verses will be read out to you in Chinese. You follow with your own Bible.
路加福音21章，有人谈论圣殿是用美食和供物装束的。耶稣说。 论到你们所看见的这一切，将来的日子到了，在这里没有一块石头留在石头上，不被拆毁了。他们问他说：“夫子，什么时候有这事呢？这将到的时候有什么预兆呢？”耶稣说：“你们要谨慎，不要受迷惑。” 因为将来有好些人冒我的名来说我是基督，又说时候近了，你们不要跟从他们。你们听见打仗的和扰乱的事，不要惊慌，因为这些事必须先有，只是末期不能立刻就到。当时，耶稣对他们说。 民要攻打民，国要攻打国，地上地要大大的震动，多处必有饥荒瘟疫，又有可怕的异象和大神迹从天上显现。但这一切的事之以先，人要下手拿住你们，逼迫你们，把你们交给会堂，并且受在监里。 因为我的名拉你们到君王诸侯面前，但这些事终必为你们的见证。所以，你们当立定心意，不要预先思想怎样分数，因为我必赐你们口才，智慧是你们一切仇敌所敌不住、搏不倒的。 连你们的父母、弟兄、亲属、朋友也要把你们交关，你们也有被他们迫而害死的。你们要为我的名被众人恨恶，然而你们连一根头发也必不损坏。你们存诚耐心，就必保全灵魂。 会必得生命，让我们同祷告。Let us pray。全能的主，我们所有的欲望你都晓得。主，我们在你面前没有可以隐藏任何的私密。求主打开我们的心门，借着宝贵四圣灵来洁净我们的心思意念，以致我们能够全然的爱你，来领受主你自己宝贵的话语。我们这样的祈求。 乃是借着我主耶稣基督的圣名而求。阿门。
阿门。
各位弟兄姊妹
，Dear brothers and sisters，
2019年以来啊
，from 2019，
我们看到这个地球上灾难事情不断的发生。
We have seen a lot of disasters, catastrophe happening in this world.
一场可怕的瘟疫，新冠病毒，迄今为止还没有结束。
And we have seen a pandemic. This COVID has not end yet.
近三年来，新冠病毒彻底改变世人的生活的方式。
For these 3 years, COVID pandemic has changed the way we live our lives.
同样，我也看到这场瘟疫啊，也冲击着我们教会弟兄姊妹的普通生活和信仰生活。
And most importantly, I could see that COVID has changed the way we as Christians live our life.
另外，从今年二月以来啊。
And then from February of last year,
这场俄罗斯与乌克兰之间的战争啊，其实是一场世界大战。
Actually, from February of this year, we have seen that it is sort of like a world war in Ukraine, where Russia attack Ukraine.
远远超过是两个国家之间的冲突。
On the surface, it looks like just two countries fighting against each other.
实际上，我们现在越来越看到，这是俄美之间一场可怕的战争。
But then, if you look under the surface, you would find that Europe and U.S. are actually at war as well.
近年来的气候的变化。
And then we look at the climate change.
自然生成的条件也正在改变。
And you would find that the natural conditions that we live in keep changing.
耶稣这里提到的饥饿是否不久也会在世界范围内出现呢？
And then in the passage we have just read, there is a mention of famines. And the question is, when will that happen?
所以我们看到无论是饥饿、战争、瘟疫，都正在应验主耶稣的预言。
So we can see that whether it be pandemic, famine, or wars, all these are happening right before our eyes.
那么在这个末世的时代，我们又当怎样预备自己来等候主耶稣的再次降临？
And so in these end times, how do we prepare ourselves for the return of our Lord Jesus Christ?
所以我今天愿意跟弟兄姊妹一起来思考一个主题啊，就是。
That's why today I have set my topic as preparing for the Lord's return.
所以这些让我们来看的是从主耶稣的话语来看。我们首先来看马太福音的21章的第6节啊。
And let us go back to the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, and we will look at Matthew chapter
路加福音，是对不起啊。
We are going to look at Luke chapter 21 verse 6.
好，主耶稣说，论到你们所看见的这一切，将来日子到了，在这里没有一块石头留在石头上不被拆毁了。
Jesus said, "As for what you see here." The time will come when not one stone will be left on another. Every one of them will be thrown down.
那我们这里所看到的主耶稣讲的这个将来的日子，其实就是指的末世的日子。
And Jesus at that time said, the time will come. What is that time? That is the end times.
那么这个日子到底是从什么时候开始的？就是末世这个日子是从什么时候开始
？And then the end days, when do they start?
我们知道教会里有很多各种各样的说法
，And we know that there are a lot of explanations and theories in the church.
但是我们一定要从圣经上来看
，But then we must always come back to the Bible.
其实这个日子末世的日子就是主耶稣复活升天之后就开始了末世。
And when Jesus talked about the end days, it has started the day Jesus rose from the dead and ascended into heaven.
那使徒约翰在约翰一书的第二章的十八节他这么说。
And then Apostle John in 1 John chapter 2 verse 8, he said,
可以翻一下。使徒约翰说，小子们啊，如今就是末时了。你们曾听见说那敌基督的要来，现在已经有好些敌基督的出来了，从此我们就知道如今是末时了。
And John said, you little ones, you have heard of the end days. Actually, let me tell you, the end days have already come. You have heard of people preaching in my names andYou have heard people who come in my name.
所以我们看到，无论教会里有各种各样的说法，神学院有各种各样的教导，但是我们回到圣经来看，末世的日子是从耶稣复活升天之后就开始了。
And we know there are many theories and explanations in the church, but coming back to the Bible, you would see clearly that the end day started as soon asJesus ascended into heaven.
而且同时是敌基督开始出现了。
And then it is from the days the Antichrist will come.
敌基督不是外面的啊。
And they are not from outside.
敌基督是从教会里面 出来的、啊。
You will find that actually the Antichrist will be from the church, within the church.
那我们看到，我们再来看主耶稣所预言的讲的圣殿要被毁这件事情。
And then we go back to the verse we just read about the temple being destroyed.
那在公元七十年耶路撒冷被攻陷，整个圣殿被毁。
In AD 70, Jerusalem was attacked and the temple was totally destroyed.
那主耶稣的预言得到了应验。
That was the time Jesus' words was fulfilled.
如今在耶路撒冷的圣殿山上，我们可以看到仅仅留下的一块石头，一个遗址啊。
Now you see a temple in Jerusalem, but there you would see there is a piece of stone.
但是在圣殿山上，如今建的是很大的一个清真寺。
But then on that holy mount, it is not a synagogue, it is a mosque.
你可以天天听到在那里。那穆斯林啊在祷告
，and you would hear these Muslims called to prayers.
用那个高音喇叭一直在播放
，and there's a microphone calling out to the faithful.
那你就让我们看到这个事，主耶稣的应验过去就发生过了。
And then when you see and hear that, you would personally feel that the words of Jesus Christ have come to pass.
2000年来的其他的事情也在不断的发生。
And for these over 2000 years, many other things have happened.
那就是在刚才路加福音21章的10到10节啊。
And that was where we see in our passage, Luke chapter 21, starting from verse 10.
主耶稣说，民要攻打民，国要攻打国，地要有大大的震动，多处有饥荒瘟疫，又有可怕的异象和大神迹从天上显现。
And Jesus said, people will rise against people, nations will rise against nation, and there will be earthquakes, famines, andthey are going to be fearful events and great signs from heaven.
我们看到这里就耶稣就预言到了战争，还有呢瘟疫，还有呢就是饥荒。
And this is here you see Jesus has prophesied war, pandemic, famines.
所以两千年来啊，
And for these 2,000 years,
我们都学过一些教会的历史或者世界的历史，我们知道。
And we know from the history of the world, the history of the church.
无论是我们看整个 世界的历史还是教会的历史都应验了主耶稣的预言，就是要国攻打国，民攻打民。
Whether we see the world history or the history of the church, you would find that there have been instances of people against people and nation against nation.
我们知道，无论是世界范围的战争，还是地域性的局部战争，从来就没有停止过。
And we all know that whether it is a world war, the world at war, or they are just a few nations fighting against each other, these wars have never stopped.
尤其我们看到从第二次世界大战之后啊，美国在日本长岛丢了两颗原子弹之后啊，开始建立什么联合国。
And especially after the Second World War,and how U.S. dropped two atomic bombs on Japan, and then we have the United Nations.
我们知道全世界人民都盼望着要和平，不要战争。
We know that the people in this world, they look for peace, they don't want war.
然后联合国这个世界的组织的宗旨也是要为了维护世界的和平。
And for the United Nations, the charter calls for world peace.
要防止各种各样的战争。
And try to avoid wars.
可是事实上是怎么样回事情呢？
But what does reality looks like?
我们看到联合国里面的各种各样的组织啊。
We see that the different organizations under the UN.
各种各样的世界性的组织。
And all these worldwide different organizations.
这个组织的本身，各种各本身就在打架。
You will find that within those very organizations, there are people, nations who are fighting.
我们看到这个联合国的，如果我们讲防止战争，民族跟民族之间，国家之间的战争，从来就没有停止过。
You will find that even though the UN Charter calls for world peace, but the war has been going on all the time.
所以联合国这样的组织只是一个人，我们讲的人的一个美好的愿望，一个乌托邦的想法，哦，我们可以得到世界的和平。
And this is looks like just people's aspiration that they will have peace, but it never happened.
根本不可能阻止战争的。
UN has never been able to stop wars from happening.
那么我们今年大家都关心的就是俄罗斯与乌克兰的这场战争。
And today we are very concerned about what's happening in Ukraine and with Russia.
那更加应验了主耶稣的预言。
And this even more fulfilled the words of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们看到乌克兰跟俄罗斯他们是同个民族，同一个根，又有同样的信仰。
We find that the people of Ukraine and Russia, they have the same roots. Actually, they almost speak the same language.
不仅仅language，还有文化那个宗教信仰，他们都是。
Even the religion, culture, they have the same root.
我们看到事实啊，两个兄弟在打架。
And you would find that actually it is two brothers fighting against each other.
那么这是从战争我们看到现今的这个世界，第二个就是刚才提到的是2019年以来这场新冠病毒啊，瘟疫啊。
That was a war that was mentioned in the passage. Now we look at the pandemic which started from 2019.
我们过去总是想到这个新冠这个病毒啊，总会与什么来对比，西班牙的那场瘟疫来对比啊，两年以后就会过去了。
And then before 2019, when we talk about flu or respiratory illness, we always think back to the Spanish flu, which says after 2 years, it's back to normal.
人总是这样去预，用人的方式去预测，去看这样的一种病毒啊。
And this is how people look at these virus.
或者去看这样的一个瘟疫。
Or this pandemic.
所以你看啊，尽管当今科学技术啊是如此先进发达。
You would see that we have made so much scientific advances And the medical science has come a long way.
但是对于一个小小的病毒啊, 却束手无策。
But then there is still no answer to this little virus.
你会发现人真的是很可怜的, 到现在为止都说不清这个病毒的起源到底怎么发生的。
And you would find out how people do not know for sure how all this started.
我们可以解释它是自然界的所造成的，或者是实验室的泄露等等，都没有证据的。
We might say it is a mutation in the natural world, or there is some kind of leak from a research lab, but then we have no proof.
然后我们再来反过来看疫苗吧。
And then we come to the so-called cure, the vaccine.
我们看到这几年来都是让大家来打各种各样的疫苗吧。
You would find that these past few years, people have been taking vaccination.
各种各样的疫苗，各个国家的疫苗，你会感到啥？令人非常失望。
And then there are different types of vaccines made by different countries, but you find that you will become hopeless.
我们从第一针、第二针、第三针、第四针、第五针，然后打下去吧。
You had the first dose, the second dose, third, fourth, fifth, it goes on.
那你会发现一个事情。
And then you will find that this has happened.
就是人非常无助。
That humans are so helpless.
人也非常无奈。
And then we are so impatient, like don't know what to do.
我们不得不去相信, 或者甚至我用了迷信, 科学家怎么说的, 医学家怎么说的。
And then it seems that we just have to accept what these scientists say. We sometimes come to the point of being superstitious.
我们看到人真的是很可怜，我们会迷信医学、药物学、免疫学。
That we blindly believe what the scientists say, what these doctors say, and whatever they said.
但是 令人痛心可悲的是什么呢?
But then what is the most pitiful part of all this?
我们又有多少基督徒真正的转眼仰望定睛在主耶稣基督的身上?
In all these circumstances, how many of us Christians, we turn our eyes on Jesus and look full in his face?
我们很多人可能不同意，我们也在那里祷告，我们来再求问主。
Some of you might say, this is not true. We have been praying. We have been asking God to help us.
那我们怎么祷告?
But then, how do we pray?
我们怎样祈求?
And what type of prayers do we offer up?
我们的信仰是不是建立在主耶稣自己的这个应许或者在预言上面?
Is our faith founded on the words and promises of Jesus Christ?
其实我相信这三年来主耶稣对我们每个人都是一个 challenge 或者是对我们的信仰的一个考验。
And I'm sure all these 3 years have been a challenge to our faith.
主耶稣透过这样的一个瘟疫,
And Jesus Christ through this pandemic,
主耶稣让我们每个人来检查我的信仰。
He wants us to look into our own hearts.
其实我真的是盼望我们在家里的弟兄姊妹啊, 我们真的是要有勇气来参加在这里的实体的敬拜。 实体敬拜,我再三强调跟家里敬拜是完全不同的。
And I especially want to speak to brothers and sisters who are online. You need to be here because being here is very different. It's a different experience.
所以我们要知道, 这场瘟疫是带给我们主要让我们学习的操练我们什么我们的信心。
And so I think the lesson to be learned from this pandemic is this is a test of our faith.
我们对他的依赖,我们对他的信靠的程度。
And how much do we rely on our faith?
讲到底就是我们生命,我们属灵生命的
And to put it bluntly, it is our spiritual life, what level it is at.
我们再来看讲到关于主耶稣预言的饥荒啊。
And then we come to the part about famine, there's no food.
我相信很多人读了以后会心里在笑笑。
And I'm sure when you read about famine, you might smile within yourself.
我很多人觉得现在已经到了21世纪了。
Because you would say in your heart, we are right now in 21st century.
不可能发生的。
And famine does not happen now.
最多我们听到在非洲一些比较贫穷的国家里面有饥荒。
At least not in North America. Maybe in Africa where the people are poor.
不要说将来还会有这种饥荒的发生。
And then even in the future, we don't think famine will ever occur.
我们总觉得现在的科学技术这各种各样改造基因的方式就停一下啊，就在这。
We know that with the farming scientific advance in farming plus genetic engineering of these crops,
让那个粮食产量可以成倍的增加，所以绝对不会存在什么这个饥荒的问题，粮食的问题。
You will find that the yield of the crops have multiplied so many times that there's no question of shortage.
前两天我收到一个邮件或者一个网上一个视频就谈到这样的问题。
And a few days ago, I got something on the internet which touched on this topic.
其实这几年来也一直在谈论什么关于改造基因的问题。
And these few years, people have been talking about genetic engineering.
这不仅仅是一个科学的问题，其实也是涉及到我们的信仰问题。
And this is not just something scientific. Actually, it touches on our faith.
因为在这里不能展开，我只能很快的带给大家。人可以改造上帝所排列好的物种的归类吗？
The question is, can people change the genetic code that God has put in these crops?
我问了大家一个很简单的事情。
And I have just this simple question to ask.
人现在都是男的可以变女的，女的可以变男的，是不是？
You would find that medically speaking, a human male can become a female and a human female can become a male.
是不是违背上帝的？
Isn't this against the will of God?
是上帝的创造吧。
We are created in the image of God.
同样的原理，你改基因的时候一定是违背神的旨意的。
Applying the same principle, so changing the genetic codes is against the will of God.
然后我们再看到这几年来啊，的气候的变化，全球的气温的在变暖。
And then we look at our world today, the climate change, how the temperature keep rising.
那自然环境被污染、被破坏的程度是如此的严重。
How the natural world has become so polluted and the climate has changed so much.
我们听到许许多的报道在讲到这个地球啊，已经破坏到了几乎无法再生存的地步。
And then we have heard reports that the environment in this earth has degraded so much that it is hardly sustaining life.
但是你会看到很可笑的一件事情。
And then you would find that something really funny happened.
世界的各个大国啊，都在一起要召开会议，在讲环保的问题，是不是？
And then all the industrialized nations of this world, they have conference on the climate change.
你看这些国家在谈论关于环保，都是要相信人靠自己可以解决这个问题。
And then when they talk about environmental protection, it is all about people doing something to protect the earth.
他们不晓得，他们也不相信主耶稣在2000年之前就讲的预言。
And then they don't know or they don't want to know that Jesus 2,000 years ago have talked about these same things.
所以对我们来说, 你看到人, 我们是相信人在那里, 靠人自己解决, 这样的问题, 还是我们相信这些所有的事情都会发生的。
And then when we look at the world today, do we feel that we as human we can find a solution or that actually God has said these things will happen?
那我们再来看主耶稣的讲的。
And now let us turn to the words of our Lord Jesus Christ.
是在路加福音的21章的12到13节啊，他主耶稣。
And then we are reading from Luke chapter 21, verse 12 to 13.
主耶稣当时的时候是在对门徒这么说的。
At that time, Jesus was speaking to his disciples.
在这一切事情的发生之前啊,
Jesus said, but before all this,
人们要拿住你们, 逼迫你们, 把你们交给会堂, 并且受在监里, 又为我的名, 拉你们到君王诸侯面前, 但这些事, 终必为你们的见证。
He said, they will lay hands on you and persecute you. They will deliver you to synagogues and prisons, and you will be brought before kings and governors, and all on account of my name. This will result in you, in your being witnesses to them.
我们看到2000年之前主耶稣的预言,
We have seen how 2,000 years ago, the prophecies of our Lord Jesus Christ.
主耶稣复活升天之后, 门徒四处传福音, 接踵而来的就是逼迫。
How after Jesus ascended into heaven, the disciples went out to preach. And then after they have started preaching, then the persecution started.
各位弟兄姊妹, 我们一定要认识到一个问题, 传福音同时伴随的就是逼迫。
And we must understand this point very clearly. Once we start preaching the gospel, then persecution will follow.
除非你是传另一个福音。
Of course, if you shared a different type of gospel,
这不是福音了，不是写,
which is not the gospel.
那我们看到主耶稣的12个门徒, 除了犹大之外, 他10个门徒都是为主殉道的。
We have seen that of the 12 disciples of Jesus, we take out Judas, and then 10 of the 11, they were martyrs.
那使徒约翰除外,
and only Apostle John died a natural death.
其实我们知道主耶稣是要特别使用他这位所爱的门徒,
because Jesus wanted to use this disciple whom he loved.
那我们看到使徒约翰在老年的时候, 他在巴摩海岛的时候, 主耶稣让他把看见的, 所听见的, 经历到的, 让他写下了这本启示录。
And then Jesus has a different plan for John. John, in his old age, he was at the Patmos Island, and then he wrote down what he had heard, what he see, and we have the book of Revelation.
那我们再看, 基督教传到了中国,
and then we see that as the gospel reached mainland China,
我们远的不说, 我们就讲, 近期的时候,
we do not talk about things that happened long time ago, just recently.
大家都知道的义和团的时候, 八国联军攻, 跟中国, 在打仗的时候, 传教士进入到中国, 接下来就是, 就是迫害, 就是殉道。
Civil war in China?
No, boxing. Boxing. Boxer.
What do you say?
Uprising.
Yeah. Yihe
Tang. Yihe. Boxer rebellion. Boxer rebellion. 共产党听到了要骂。
We know that in the Boxer's rebellion, the missionaries arrive in China, but then they are persecuted.
你到网上可以看到许许多多的都是为主殉道血流成河的。
And then you would find that so many people have died that you would say there were rivers of blood.
所以他们的流血为福音做了美好的见证。
So that shedding of a blood is a testimony to the gospel.
这就是因为主耶稣自己讲的，你们就会成为这个美好的见证嘛。
That is exactly what Jesus said. You will be dragged before people, and you will be my witnesses.
那最近我在学习启示录啊。
And recently, I have been studying the book of Revelation.
我们知道一开始的时候，主耶稣让使徒约翰要为他做见证嘛。
And we know that Jesus wanted John to be a witness for him.
大家要知道见证这个词啊。
And to be a witness.
在希腊的原文里啊，跟哪个词是同义词？殉道是同义词。
In the original Greek word, it comes from the root word of martyr.
各位弟兄姊妹，见证就是殉道啊。Actually,
to be a witness means to die as martyr.
你要真正的传扬福音的时候，你要有个心智，要准备是为主殉道的。So
when you talk about sharing the gospel, it means that you may have to die for the gospel.
各位弟兄姊妹。 其实现在全世界的教会都面临着一种大的逼迫。
And actually, the church worldwide is facing a type of persecution.
这种逼迫的话，其实比有形的把你杀掉更可怕。
And this type of persecution is even more dangerous as just killing you. It is more than that.
魔鬼是要各种各样的方法来改变我们的。
Actually, the Satan is using different methods to change our core belief.
我们刚才就提到的，无论是战争也好，瘟疫也好，可能还有我们想面临的这个饥饿，各种各样的事情是魔鬼在逼迫教会。
And we have seen that whether it be wars, famine, or pandemic, or things that have not yet happened, these are the things that will change us.
我们常常不会去注意到这些。
And then sometimes these changes happen without us noticing.
我们常常觉得，哎呀，瘟疫2000年来一直都有的是，我们相信科学家的话，这些都是在自然界早就存在的各种各样的病毒。
And then regarding the pandemic, we say that because the virus has been there all along, and then we'll just listen to the signs.
战争们总是存在的。
And then these wars have been there all along.
饥饿啊，过去啊，现在没有啦。And
then famine is in the past. We won't have famine anymore.
所以你会发现，他要在用这样，魔鬼是用这样的方法来改变我们的信仰，来向我们的信仰挑战。And
here you see how Satan changed our belief and then challenged our belief.
各位弟兄姊妹，我们是不是认识到这是一种很大的挑战？魔鬼要来攻陷我们灵里内在的信仰。
Do we ever notice that all these are avenues of attack for the Satan? How he wants to change our belief?
所以，各位弟兄姊妹，这就是我们看啊，主耶稣，在这个第八节里面提到的。
And this is what we see. Jesus said in verse 8,
耶稣说，你们要谨慎，不要受迷惑，因为将来有好些人冒我的名，说我是基督，又说时候近了，你们不要跟从他们。Jesus
replied, Watch out that you are not deceived, for many will come in my name, claiming I am he, and the time is near, do not follow them.
刚才我们也提到，使徒约翰在约翰一书第二章时候就提到的这个敌基督啊，已经出来了。And
then we have mentioned that in First John, Apostle John have said the Antichrist has already appeared.
2000年来在教会里从来没有少过，就是敌基督的在教会的当中。In
the history of the church for 2,000 years. You would find that Antichrist has been present in the church.
最可怕的是什么呢?
And what is the most fearful thing?
就是读保罗讲的。
That is what Paul said.
魔鬼撒旦会装扮成什么光明的天使来欺骗我们。
That Satan, he will be disguised as a shining angel.
那各位弟兄姊妹，如今现在是什么样的时代？
Dear brothers and sisters, what kind of times are we living in?
现在是个网络的时代。
We are living in the age of internet.
是个多媒体的时代。
And then we live in a multimedia society.
更是一个各媒体的时代，每个人都可以写东西嘛。
And then we have so much freedom of speech that we can say whatever we want.
人人都可以在网上散布各样的信息。
And then people, they send out different types of information on the internet.
你真假难辨。
And it is so difficult to differentiate between what is real and what is fake.
因为人的罪恶，人的罪恶就是让人家知道自己嘛。
And then, this is our sinful nature that we want to show ourselves.
所以你一定要知道，魔鬼撒旦就是会利用这样的工具来在教会当中在欺骗。
And this is how the Satan used this type of tools to deceive people in the church.
因为在网上有铺天盖地有各种各样的信息，你知道真假吗？
In the internet, there is so much information, you don't know what is true and what is fake.
你能够分辨吗？
Can you differentiate?
你知道什么是好草，什么是毒草吗？
Do you know what are the good grass and what are the poisonous one?
你往往为了自己的满足，喜欢吃自己喜欢的所谓的草。
And then we are always looking for something we like, the grass that we see.
各位弟兄姊妹，我们一定要小心。
We need to be very careful.
我们不要掉以轻心，就会落入了魔鬼的陷阱。
We should not be casual. If we are casual, then we will be entrapped.
所以我们为什么主祷文每天要让我们来祷告，让我们不要陷入试探。
That is why in the Lord's Prayer, there is that part which say, do not lead us into temptation.
是，让我们不要陷入魔鬼的陷阱。
That we will not fall into the traps of the Satan.
所以各位弟兄姊妹，没有其他的办法，我们唯有祷告，祷告，再祷告。
So there's no other way except to pray. We just need to keep praying.
求主怜悯我。
May the Lord have mercy on us.
让我有一个分辨的真假的能力。
That I can differentiate between the real things and the fake things.
不是我自己做得到的。
It is not something that we can do on our own.
不是靠我自己的智慧能力我可以分辨的。
With our wisdom and with our strength, we cannot differentiate.
跟你所有的知识无关。
And this has nothing to do with your head knowledge.
跟你过去所有的经历无关。
And it has nothing to do with your personal experience.
唯有要圣灵来帮助我。
Only the Holy Spirit can help you.
赐给我们一个分辨真假的灵。
Give us the heart of discernment to be discern the good from the evil.
让我们看最后主耶稣又讲的一句话。
And then we come to the last section of what Jesus said.
你们长存忍耐，就必保全灵魂，或者是翻译是生命。
And then he says, we need to be patient, and then we can keep our life.
好，各位弟兄姊妹
，Dear brothers and sisters，
我在准备这个讲章的时候，我特别去看了马太福音二十四章的十三到十四节。
And then while preparing this, I went back to look at Matthew chapter 23, verse 13 and 14.
那么路加福音在这里讲的是，你们长存忍耐，就必保全灵魂。
Here in Luke, Jesus said, stand firm and you will win life.
在马太福音二十四章，耶稣怎么说的呢？耶稣说，唯有忍耐到底。必然得救。
And in Matthew, Jesus said, if you only say true, to the very end, then you will be safe.
我们常常会混淆的啊。
Very often we become unsure.
我已经得救了。That
I am already safe.
我还会要得救啊。And
do I need to be safe again?
好，我们把这个问题放在这里，放在我们今天不来争论这个问题啊。Let
us keep this question aside. We'll touch on it later.
我们知道在教会里常常会争论救恩会不会失去的问题，是不是？
And then, in the church, there's always this question: Will I someday lose my salvation?
一次得救，永远得救的问题啊。Whether
once safe, I am forever safe.
我们不陷入这种神学上的争论。We
are not going into the theology of this.
我们来看主耶稣的这句话。We
are just going to look at what Jesus said.
主耶稣的预言。
The prophecy of Jesus.
在路加医生所记载的，跟使徒马太所记载的，我们要把这两个综合起来来看。
As recorded by Dr. Luke and the other one by Matthew, let's put them together and see.
英文的话呢是 win your life, 或者呢是 win your souls.
In Luke it says win your life or win your soul.
那 马太福音呢, 就是, should be saved.
And in Matthew, it says, should be saved.
好, 那, 我个人的体会来告诉大家啊,
and I want to share my personal experience.
我们要把这两者放在一起, 可以完整的靠主来帮助我能够一个正确的, 哦, 不叫正确, 比较完整的去理解啊。
And then we need to put these two verses side by side and make it complete.
各位弟兄姊妹，主耶稣的意思就是说，为了主耶稣的缘，一切是要为主耶稣的缘故啊，我们要忍耐，忍受一切的苦难。先听着。And
this is what Jesus said. Everything is for Jesus. We need to be patient and we need to stand firm in persecution.
然后要准备经历各种形形色色的逼迫。
And then we will face different types of persecution.
我们最终会像主耶稣那样的得胜。
And finally, we will be like Jesus, will be victorious.
战胜魔鬼的一切的试探。
And we will have victory over the temptations of Satan.
也是我们灵魂的什么得胜。
And it will be a victory for our soul.
在主耶稣来的日子,
and on the day of Jesus' return,
也就是他最后来的日子,
and on the last day,
我们可以经历到这种完全的得救。
And we can experience complete salvation.
所以你看, 这是主耶稣让我们看到的一个极其重要的真理。
This is the important truth that Jesus wants us to see.
主耶稣这样的预言,
this prophecy of Jesus,
让我们看到2000年来在这个末世的时代,
that for 2000 years coming to the end days,
过去现在都会经历到战争, 瘟疫跟各种各样的那种自然灾害或者就是饥饿。
We have been experiencing war, pandemic, and then famine.
背后的都是一场属灵的战争。
Underneath all these, it is a spiritual warfare.
就是主让我们靠着圣灵跟魔鬼撒旦的一场战争。
That we are waging a war with Satan with the help of Holy Spirit.
主耶稣让我们面对我们各种各样的挑战，我们要忍耐。
And then when faced with different challenges, we need to have patience.
所谓的忍耐，我们不要很快的就做出很多跟着世界的反应。
And being patient does not mean that we try to respond or have reactions to the things happening in this world.
忍耐有一个我自己的理会，就是要在主面前好好的祷告，祷告再祷告。
To me, patience is praying before God. We just keep on praying.
我们只有在这样的祷告的环境当中，
And then in this atmosphere of prayer,
我们一祷告, 我们就是个得胜的开始。
And as we pray, you would find that that is the beginning of our victory.
魔鬼是最害怕我们去祷告的。
And Satan becomes very afraid when we start praying.
我首先还要强调一下，是按照主的心意去祷告，不是按照我的心意来祷告。
And I need to mention that when we pray according to God's will, not what we want.
当我们靠着祷告，我们一定是已经把魔鬼撒旦的这些阴谋啊。
And when we start praying, it means that we have been able to take away all these traps that Satan has set for us.
我们靠着祷告,
and then when we pray, we are victorious. This is what we need to know.
因为你,各位弟兄姊妹,
In our hands, there is no other weapons except prayer.
是我们得胜的武器。
And this will lead us to victory.
主耶稣在十字架上, 他怎么样得胜的? 他今天也是要让我们能够得胜。
The way that Jesus had victory on the cross, the same way he wants to give us that victory.
得胜魔鬼撒旦的权势。
That we will have victory over the powers of Satan.
今天要让我们得胜, 我们对
And then we have victory over the fears of our flesh.
因为我们看到主耶稣是从死里复活的生命的主。
And because our Lord Jesus Christ rose from the dead, He is the Lord of life.
他复活的生命在我们里面, 你不会对现在肉身的生命还有任何的惧怕。
His resurrected life is in us. We should not be afraid of the fears of the flesh.
求主怜悯我们,
May the Lord have mercy on us.
让我们要预备我们自己,
that we will prepare ourselves.
在末世的时代,
that in these end days,
我们天天要警醒,
that we need to be watchful.
我们不断地要思考主耶稣的话语,
that we need to be reminded of the word of our Lord Jesus.
我们要提醒我们自己, 我们每个人要提醒自己,
that we will remind each one of ourselves.
我将来主耶稣来的时候, 我怎么能够站立得稳, 站立得住, 在主面前, 让他来审判。
That when the Lord comes, I can stand firm, I can stand up to the judgment.
这是我们的信仰。
This is our faith.
这是非常严肃的一个信仰,
and this is very serious.
而且是我们一个本质的一个信仰,
and this is the core of our faith.
不是随随便便的一件事情,
and this is not something casual.
是我们每天在生活当中我们都要去思考去面对的事情。
This is something that we have to think about in our daily life.
因为主来的日子近了。
Because the day of our Lord is drawing very near.
主任何时候都可能来。
And Jesus can come back anytime.
你我相信吗?
Do you believe that?
你有准备好了吗?
Have you prepared yourself?
求主怜悯。
May the Lord have compassion on us.
让我们同祷告。
Let us pray.
全的主，我们来到你的面前。 主，你知道我们属灵的光景。 主，你自己的话语再一次来光照我们。 让我们要转眼仰望，定睛在你自己的身上，对你的话语有更深的认识，更深的体会。尤其在这个末世的时代，有战争，有瘟疫，甚至可能还会面临的这种饥荒，但是我们不惧怕。所以我们也晓得，在这些事情发生之前， 你让我们要经历的，就是魔鬼撒旦的，对我们进行各种各样的逼迫。求主让我们能够在耶稣基督里能够站立的稳，持守我们纯正的信仰。谢谢主，我们这样的祈求感谢的是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求。阿门。
Thank you, Pastor Chu, Zhu, for the message and Brother Keith for the interpretation.
我们谢谢朱牧师的正道，还有阿丽弟兄的翻译。
In response, let's sing more like the Master.
要我们做个回应的时候，我们一起来唱《更像我恩主》。
Scripture of this week is taken from 1 John chapter 4 verse 7.
我们来念本周的经句，是在约翰一书的第四章第七节。
Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God.
亲爱的弟兄啊，我们应当彼此相爱。 因为爱是从神来的，凡有爱心的，都是由神而生，并且认识神。
Now is the time for welcome and announcement.
现在是欢迎和报告的时间。
We welcome all the brothers and sisters who are seated here, and also all of the brothers and sisters who are streaming online at home.
我们再次欢迎在座的每一位的弟兄姐妹，还有在线上跟我们一起敬拜的弟兄姐妹们。
So let's go to the announcement. Our Sunday worship is still streaming online every Sunday at 10:30 in the church office. For those in person, if you are in the church office, and those online will be gracelingliang.online.church. And prayer meeting are on Tuesday at 8 p.m. And Sunday school for the children and other fellowship are still online through Zoom. So we encourage all the brothers and sisters to participate.
教会每周十点钟，有十点三十分有主日崇拜，我们可以在这里办公室，还有在椅子脸书网上全部的形式进行，可以去 gracelingliang.online.church，然后周二晚上八点钟的祷告，有祷告会，然后有儿童主义学以及其他团契，将以 Zoom 传播的形式来举行，欢迎弟兄姐妹们来参加。
And we request all the brothers and sisters for your offerings and love gifts. You can send through indirect e-transfer to gracelingliangchurch@gmail.com or using online banking or mailing checks to the church office. So we prefer you to send your love gifts via e-transfer during this time of pandemic.
感谢弟兄姐妹爱心奉献，使用 interact with Grace Ling Liang Church at gmail.com， 然后电子银行转账或者是机票。在疫情锁定期间，敬请最好将你的奉献通过电子银行来转账。
And this coming Friday, that is, Saturday, November 19 at 7:30 in the church office, we will have a Bethany Fellowship that is in person. So we welcome all the families and youth and children to join for this coming Saturday fellowship.
博大里团契将于11月19号星期六晚上7点30分在教会的办公室，我们有实体的这一个的团契，欢迎所有年轻的家庭和成员以及青少年和儿童来参加。
Shall we all stand? Let's sing doxology and request Pastor Chiu for the benediction.
我们一起起立来唱三一颂，还有请邱牧师为我们来祝福。
普天之下，万国万民，齐声赞美父之圣灵，三位一体同荣同尊，万有之源，万福之本。
继续站立，让我们接受主的祝福。但愿主耶稣基督的恩惠、父神的大爱、圣灵的交通与感动，常与众弟兄姊妹们同在，从今直到永永远远。阿门。Shall we receive God's benediction? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, fellowship and the communion of God the Holy Spirit.Be with us now and forevermore.
Amen. Amen. Have a word of silent prayer and see you all next Sunday again.
请坐，末后三会，我们下个星期再见。